Hello everyone, today we are going to talk on the topic Hindu Marriage Act and the conditions required for a valid Hindu Marriage Act. Certain conditions must be met for a marriage to be valid in the eyes of law. In case a ceremony takes place but the necessary conditions are not met with, the marriage is either void by default or voidable. The conditions stated in the Section 5 of the Act are as follows. No party should be already married, that is neither party should have a spouse living at the time of marriage. Thus, this act prohibits polygamy. At the time of marriage, neither party should be incapable of giving valid consent due to unsoundness of mind. Even if he or she is capable of giving valid consent, should not be suffering from a mental disorder to an extent which makes him or her unfit for marriage and procreation of children. He or she should not be subject to recurring attacks of insanity either. The party should not be underage. The bridegroom should be a minimum of 21 years of age and the bride should be at least 18 years old. The party should not spindas or within the degrees of prohibited relationship unless any custom governing them allows marriage between such relations. What are void marriages under Hindu Marriage Act? According to Section 11 of the Act, a marriage can even be declared null and void if either party presents a petition or if following are contravened. Either of the parties is already married and has a spouse living at the time of marriage. Either party is underage, that is groom below 21 years of age and bride below 18 years of age. The parties are spindas or within the degree of prohibited relationship. Voidable marriage under Hindu Marriage Act. According to Section 12, a marriage, although valid, can later be annulled on any of the following grounds. If either party is impotent or therefore unable to consummate the marriage, when at the time of marriage either party is not capable of giving valid consent due to unsoundness of mind, even if he or she is capable of giving valid consent, has been suffering from mental disorder to an extent which makes him or her unfit for marriage or procreation of children, or is subject to recurring attacks of insanity, if the consent was obtained forcefully or fraudulently, if the bride was pregnant by another man other than the groom at the time of marriage. Thank you.